This episode of TRS is brought to you by The Ben Heck Show, building, modding, and electronics, brought to you exclusively by Element 14. Coming up, Wes Craven and the gang are back for Scream 4.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Totally Rad Show. We've got a great week today. We are going to be talking about the new Scream movie, Scream 4, actually with a special guest. I was not able to see the movie, so you guys are going to meet a special guest, which is nice.
Yes, and then tomorrow we are going to give you a preview of a big game that will be coming out later this year called Twisted Metal. Of course, the reboot of Twisted Metal. We went to a Sony event, got to see that. Very excited.
Very nice.
And then on Wednesday, you get to find out what's on our radars with On My Radar.
Ah, or On Our Radar, My Radar? I don't know how I'll have to look at the title again. Thursday, we are finally taking a look at the new MMO, Rift, which will be very fun.
And then Friday, we're wrapping it all up with a game that you guys really liked, Title Fight.
Boom, boom, as
oh
it
Oh my
were.
Gosh, it's going
boom,
down.
Boom.
Now, a while back, we actually reviewed a sort of fun little comic called The Return of the Dapper Men. And now we've got an amazing Return of the Dapper Men background.
It's like we're dapper.
And men. Hello.
Really cool. That was sent in all the way from South Germany near Stuttgart.
Very nice.
By Verena Unsen. Thank you, Verena.
Well, shall we Verena ourselves into the show? I don't know what that means.
I hope it's something sorted.
Today in movies, we are talking about Scream 4, and unfortunately, Alex couldn't make it to the screening this week, so we have brought in our friend Melissa Molina.
We got a pinch hitter.
Yeah, we sure do. She's a writer for AMC Theaters and Latino Review, and we're excited. It's our first ever guest co-host and first female entree into the duo and the trio here.
So. Yeah.
Yeah. Let me tell you a little about Scream 4. Scream 4, sequel to Scream.
No.
Many of you have heard of Scream. Scream, big movie, influential movie. There was a glut of horror films in the 80s. We had that's where Nightmare on Elm Street, Friday the 13th, they all came out in the 80s. And then in the 90s, not so much. But Scream came on the screen, and not only brought the horror genre back, but also was the first sort of self-referential movie. You know, we had since Scream, we've had self-referential movies of all kinds of genres. But Scream was sort of the first one to instigate that. Anyway,
it was as much about slasher movies as it was a slasher movie.
Exactly. So Scream 4 is about Neve Campbell returning as Sydney Prescott. She returns to Woodsboro, the town where all these Scream movies take place. She's visiting on a book tour. And now the Ghostface killer is after her cousin, played by Emma Roberts, and all of her friends. David Arquette and Courtney Cox return as the sheriff and reporting duo. And Wes Craven is back directing. Kevin Williamson, who wrote the original Scream, and may have done the second one, I don't remember, but he didn't do the third one. He's back as well for Scream 4. I'm gonna start with you, Melissa. What did you think of, what do you think of the Scream series in general, and what did you think of Scream 4?
The Scream series is pretty fun, just in regards to like entertainment, horror, slasher value. I mean, the first one, I mean, of course, everybody's like, the original's the best, and that's how it stands like. And, second was all right. Third one isn't everybody's favorite, that's for sure. Yeah. And especially with a bunch of people who've been rewatching the three lately, they've all been like, oh my god, I don't want to remember the third one. So what Scream 4 basically does is it goes back a little bit to its roots with the first Scream movie. Like, if it finds what was great with that movie and it works on it. The biggest downfall for me is that it relies on the original too much to the point of where it feels slightly like a remake. And I also feel that they should have been a little more risky when it came to the main characters, but still overall, it's pretty good popcorn, horror slasher entertainment fun like the first one. So I would check it out if I were you.
Yeah, I liked it too. I love that what and you can correct me if I'm wrong, but I feel that what Scream brought to the genre is a real whodunit. I don't know of any other slasher movie where there's a big question. There's a lot of why done it's like, what the hell's wrong with that crazy creature that came out of somewhere? But a true mystery, like a true whodunit of who's behind that mask.
Right.
And this movie does that. Yeah, and like the first movie did, and this movie does that again. And I constantly thought I knew, and it was constantly changing my opinion of who it was. And it has a very satisfying, wonderfully fun ending. It has a brilliant beginning. The movie starts in a wonderfully meta way. And there's almost a point of which, when you're meta about being meta, we gotta come up with a new term. You're meta about the meta-ness.
Meta squared.
Super Saiyan meta.
Okay. Brilliant. But I loved it. I mean, I wish that the cleverness of the first 5 minutes of the movie carried through the entire thing. I felt like the middle of the movie waned a lot, and we got into really kind of a less than exciting slasher movie in the middle until we get to the fun resolution of the whodunit at the end, which is ridiculously fun and interesting and clever and all the things that I liked about the first Scream exist in that end and exist in the beginning. It's just a middle chunk that just kind of feels a little pedestrian. And, you know, the character of Dewey and the fun we have revisiting our old favorites isn't enough to carry this movie, I think, in the middle. It just feels a little tired when it's just a few kills that aren't particularly interesting.
Well, I mean, after a certain point in the second act, it becomes a huge shift to where they pay more attention to Emma Roberts and everybody else. And then Dewey, Gale, and Sydney all take a back seat.
Yeah,
that's true.
Daniel, what did you think?
I agree and disagree with some of the things you just said in that I thought it was absolutely genius. Absolutely genius. And I was, the opening
scene.
The whole movie. I thought the opening scene was amazing. And that's the best part about Scream, the original, was the opening scene.
Mm-hmm.
And this really
outdoes it.
Yeah, it does it and outdoes it all in one.
Yes.
Kind of what Scream is. Scream is an entry into the genre and refers to the genre, and that is all encapsulated in this opening scene. But I started to get a little bit of an uh-oh feeling as it progressed, because the characters all wear their hearts on their sleeves. Everything in this movie is very overt. There's no subtlety or nuance. It's like, I am the sheriff played by, David Arquette is like, he's that guy. He says what his motivations are. The boyfriend of the lead girl, he says what his motivation, everyone's sort of saying their exposition and motivations. However, this is such a well-designed engine or clock that you need to see those gears to understand how they all fall into place. And Wes Craven is so genius at playing with your expectations that you need to clearly see what people are trying to do to be clearly, reversed.
Fooled.
Yeah, exactly. And the end, I got to a point where I said, you know what, I don't care who the killer is, because this is all working so well, it can never live up to what I want it to be.
And then it did.
And then it didn't?
It didn't?
And then it did. You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't, but then the way it's explained is so wonderful.
No, I agree there. At first I was just kind of like, really? You just went straight like that? It's just going to be like never mind then. We're taking it an extra step further.
Exactly. Just like the opening scene took it an extra step further, the end scene takes it an extra step further. I think this is the best. I think this is how you do a sequel. I mean, I think this is one of the best sequels I've ever seen. And it certainly might be my favorite horror sequel. Can you name another good horror sequel?
Halloween 3.
That's one that's like completely different. It's not even,
I'm partial to some of those fun, campy Nightmare on Elm Streets, but I don't think they're fun filmmaking like this.
Exactly.
Hatchet 2 was a fun little sequel.
I did see the first Hatchet. I didn't like Hatchet. I didn't understand what the big deal was with Hatchet.
The first Hatchet was all right, but the second one, it was like, oh, wait, we know exactly what we are. Let's just play the hell out of that.
Interesting. Well, that is...
I don't want to mention any spoilers, and I think people should do a good job of avoiding spoilers, because the fun is the being fooled and all that those things. But I will say, I like how the movie ends up sort of being about something, and I'm wondering if you felt it was a little preachy or a little... At the end, I mean, I think it's there, but...
It is. It definitely is. It's not too preachy, but it works. It definitely does work. And yep. It just brings everything kind of full circle.
Yeah.
It really is about, so I mean.
And I love that about it.
Oh my God.
Like it has the balls to kind of go there.
Yeah.
And take a stand on an issue, really.
Yeah.
And that's awesome.
I feel like the way that we're talking, it's like we leave that blank in the middle of a sentence. It's like, so-and-so did blank today.
Yeah. Which is the Mad Libs of movie reviews.
But it, to me, the reason why I feel like it's genius, the reason why it reaches perfection to me is because when you go back, when you think about why it is, like it perfectly, it's a perfect sequel, it perfectly follows the story, right? That's what a sequel does, it continues the story. It is a, you know, the one criticism is not very scary.
And at all,
and
not even
the original Scream was terrifying to me. Yeah, I was younger than you.
But it's not. I don't think it's even trying to be scary.
It's not trying to be scary.
Exactly. Yeah,
I mean, it even touches upon throughout the film that, you know, this generation is desensitized to a certain type of gore now.
And that's it's interesting that it says that, because I found myself going, oh, it's just a stab? Like, that kill is just a stab?
And then
it comes out and goes, people are upset that there aren't creative kills and things. Yeah. And it's like, oh, you got me. Yeah. You called me on exactly my criticism.
And the movie constantly does that.
Yeah.
And you don't think you could do that, because all the sequels to Scream's all commented on horror films, but we've now come to this place where, oh, we've gone in a different direction with horror films, and not only just horror films, but it refers to other horror movies, it refers to itself within itself.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's been over 10 years since the first Scream came out, so like a lot of it's
crazy.
You know, yeah. Saw, Hostel, everything like that. And they even touch upon it too during the film. They're just like, you know, this is how it is now.
And would you guys be excited for a Scream 5? Would you want that to
happen? They can't do that.
I don't know.
I think the way where it ends is almost specifically leading up to.
No, they can't. Well, especially because you see Scream 5 in the movie, so to speak. Anyway. All right, so that's. I mean, I think we're all saying absolutely you must go.
It's great.
Definitely.
And I don't know if, I mean, I think maybe if it's scary, I mean, it's not scary, and it's not particularly overtly violent, so it's not even.
I think it'll be.
It's overtly violent.
I think it'll be a little better.
Something gory, maybe. What were you saying?
I was gonna say, I think it'll be a little bit better, at least for the younger generation that never like had any sort of Scream. Like there's this gap in time between Scream 3 and this one. I think it'll be kind of a breath of fresh air for them between all the torture, like porn and everything like that that's come out.
But if you haven't seen the first one, I think you're missing out. Like, there's enough that references that you should watch.
You don't need to see the sequel, you need to see one and then this.
But the cool thing too is that because of this, more people I noticed are starting to revisit the original three. So I think it's like, it's great in that way too.
Absolutely.
Well, thanks for joining us.
Yes, thanks for coming on board. Here we go. That's a wrap.
All right, everybody. Remember to stick around for this day in Rad History. But first, we want to thank our sponsors. Join modding wizard Ben Heck and his friends as they build and modify a host of amazing community-inspired creations.
Who these guys, are the modding wizards that came up with this one?
Guys make some crazy stuff. Be sure to watch the most recent episode of The Ben Heck Show. This week, Ben will answer questions from Element 14 and Revision 3's communities about his build. So
like,
check out...
how did the hell did you do that?
Yeah, like where did you get that machine that makes amazingness? Element14.com/TBHS to enter and to win one of Ben's most recent builds from the show, the original portable workbench. Offers end April 30th, so get those emails in. That is it for us. We will see you tomorrow. Let's do this.
Tomorrow on the show, we get our hands on some twisted metal.
So today is April 18th, and on this day in Rad history, in 2006, Toshiba launches the first HD DVD format. The first HD DVD with true HD soundtrack was The Phantom of the Opera.
And I believe you were on record.
I was on record as saying HD DVD will
be
Blu-ray.
Yeah.
I still have an HD DVD player for my Xbox 360, as well as a couple HD DVDs. They still work and play fine.
And you sit and listen to Phantom of the Opera.
I did. This is 5 years ago. Wow, that's actually a long time. I felt like that was just yesterday when that happened.
Nope, long time ago.
5 years ago.
Thank you, Ig Joe, for sending that in. IG Joe.
Dyslexic GI Joe.